I'll give you another narration about this, which is also a very important narration, which Imam Tabarani mentions, and Sayyidina A'mash radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrated that one day in the morning, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Masud radiallahu ta'ala anhu was present in a gathering, and suddenly he says, any qati' rahim, anyone who breaks ties with family members, with relatives, I give him the qasam of Allah, get up and leave. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Masud radiallahu ta'ala anhu says this. Any qati' rahim, I give him the qasam of Allah in the name of Allah, get up and leave. Because we are about to make dua of maghfirah. We are about to make a prayer of forgiveness. Get up and leave from here. Because if qati' rahim is present, the doors of the heavens are closed. If in a gathering the qati' rahim is present, the doors of the heavens are closed. Meaning if he will remain in this gathering, the doors of the heavens, the doors of mercy, the doors of rahmah, Allah Jalla wa Ala will be closed. We will not benefit. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Masud radiallahu ta'ala said this. So brothers and sisters in Islam, it is important that we act upon this. And it is also important, as I mentioned clearly from the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you want your wealth to increase, what will you do? Go to a jahil amil, go to a jahil peer, a jahil mullah, and ask him to do ta'weez upon my relatives. So, and he will tell you, so and so relative has done jadu on you. That is what he will say to you. And then you say, okay, I will have to stay away from my relatives now. In order for my wealth to increase, I have to distance myself from my relatives. That's what they say, don't they? Do not eat in his house. Do not drink in his house. She will put something in the food. The mother, she does so much jadu. This is what they say. People from here are contacting people in India, in Pakistan, and they're sending ta'weezat. It is so-and-so relative of yours. There are obstacles in your wealth. Why? Because of so-and-so person. There are problems in your wealth. There are hurdles in your wealth. So-and-so has done something against you. It is their hamla, it is their attack because of that, the obstacles. What did the Prophet ﷺ say? Rasulullah ﷺ said, if you want your properties to increase, want your properties to increase, rather than going to the amils, what does the Prophet ﷺ say? Go to your relatives. Go to your relatives. Join ties of relationship with your relatives, your properties will increase. Your wealth will increase. And your life will increase. Words of Rasulullah. And the meaning of life increasing, it means even after you are dead, your name will remain alive. People will praise you. You will be alive even after your demise, after your death. We will act upon this inshallah. We will train ourselves in the month of Ramadan inshallah. We will implement this after Ramadan inshallah. And remember, there is a big difference between Sila Rahmi, and muqafa, as I have mentioned. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam has mentioned this. Sayyidina Abdullah bin Amr bin Al-As radiyallahu ta'ala narrates, and in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, laysa al-wasilu bil muqafi walakin al-wasil al-lazi iza qutiyat rahimahu wasalaha. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, don't you think the wasil, the one who joins ties of relationship with family members, is the one who pays back for the favors? Don't you think it's that person? Meaning, if someone does a favor on you, and they say, okay, he did a favor on me, I will do a favor back on that person. That's not sila rahim. That's not a wasil. That's not the one who makes people meet. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَلَكِنَّ الْوَاسِلَ الَّذِي إِذَا قُطِعَتْ رَحِمُهُ وَصَلَهَا. Wasil is the one, if his relative closes his doors for him, he deprives him, but this relative still gives him. He denies him, but he still meets him. He oppresses him, but he still treats him in a good manner. That is a wasil. That is the one who does sila rahim. This is the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam Bukhari narrates this in his Sahih, Imam Abu Dawud in Sunan, Imam At-Tirmizi in his Sunan. So who is a wasil? What is our attitude? What is our approach? What do we do? If so and so comes to my son's wedding, then I will go to his son's wedding. If they come to our khatam, then we will go to their khatam. And we think that's sila rahim. No, that's not sila rahim. That is mukafat. Mukafat is to pay back for favors. Your wealth, if you want your wealth to increase, if you want your properties to increase, if you want to live for long, and if you want people to have love for you, and if you want your name to remain alive in this dunya, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the one who deprives you, give it to him. The one who oppresses you, do favors on him. How do you do that? You invite someone to your son's wedding. to your daughter's nikah, a khatam, another gathering, a funeral, someone has passed away in your family, one of your relatives, he doesn't come to your house, he doesn't come to the funeral, what do we say? If he's not going to come, then I'm not going to go. I eat in my own house. No, I'm not on the streets, am I? If they will not come, then why should we go? We haven't done nozul. We haven't done, we haven't oppressed. We are good people. We are pious people. We unite people. We bring people together. But think about it. We are not okay. We are not hungry people. Do you understand that? That's what they say to us. Hum apne ghar se khate hain, bhai. Why should we go to their house? The Prophet said, Sila rahmi. If you want your life to increase, if you want your properties to increase, if you want your wealth to increase, if you invite someone, he doesn't come when it's his son's wedding, you still have to go to his house. That is Sila Rahim. If you do that, then you will get this reward.